The hospitality industry constitutes a large part of the tourism sector, generating huge income and boosting the economy of any nation. It is a thriving sector that attracts both public and private investment interests from foreigners and indigenous alike. However, the industry recently suffered a huge setback as a result of the COVID-19 pandemic, which grossly affected investors, employers, and employees in the sector worldwide. In a recent interview with Comrade William Iye, the president of the Hotel and Personal Services Senior Staff Association, during the association's National Executive Council meeting for executives and stakeholders at the Airport Hotel Ikeja, Lagos, the comrade emphasized that employees suffered a huge setback. However, the union has risen up to the occasion in cushioning the effects.
This particular neck, is focused on the way out of COVID-19, after COVID-19 illness. What we are solving right now all over the country is downsizing of workers. And our workers are getting, discouraged. Our workers are getting to feel that, what happened next? Is this person today? What happened to the next person tomorrow? And we are trying to let them know that unions still remain. And we encourage them to be steadfast in whatever they are doing, especially in the service they are rendering. Because we want to know that COVID is already and gradually winding up here. And we want to believe that as much or as soon as the business returns, definitely the issue of downsizing or whatever will be over. So we're encouraging them to go back to their branches, talk to the team members, to be of good courage, and then do their job as effective as possible. In the month of March, April, this virus came to destroy the whole world. And I tell you, hospitality industry is the most hit, as I'm talking to you. The hotels have gone down. Our activities have been seriously punctuated, and now we are finding it difficult to manage the situation with our employers. This is exactly where we are, if not. By now, I believe that we are supposed to have gone far in our best to organize the entire association. Since the advent of COVID-19, it has been one problem or the other from various hotels. Most of the hotels now are taking the advantage of COVID-19 pandemic to reduce drastically the strength of their workers. That has been on since the month of April. In the month of April, I can tell you one or two hotels have downsized. And when they are coming with this downsizing, they'll come with this idea that COVID-19 has taken over the whole situation in the world. There's no revenue. There's no revenue. As such, people are sent home without, recourse to paying them their benefits. But in a scenario, I can tell you one or two hotels that we have visited, they attempted to do that, but we resisted. At the end of the day, we went into negotiation. At the end of the day, even though we cannot stop them completely from doing what they intended to do, like downsizing, but then we had a very good argument, good negotiation, and at the end of the day, none of our people have been cheated where, we have a union in place.
Making mention of the benefits of the association, which covers employees in the hospitality business and also in the catering and security services business, he made it crystal clear that the association cannot fight for the rights of non-members when treated badly by their employers or when laid off.
The core interest of the association is to salvage the workforce and then to work for the interests of the members in terms of their job security, their welfare, and then their relationship too with their employers. Organizing hotel industry has been a serious challenge. But that notwithstanding, we have our staff all over the country. We have the three zones that covers the area of organizing. We have the Western Zone, the Northern Zone, and the Eastern Zone. So these zones are positioned to take care of different cities within the zone and to see the hotels that are coming up and the hotels that really need to be organized. And then in a consultation with the National Secretariat, where the General Secretary is always in place to see the affair of other zones. And in most places, you know, when you went to go for organization, to organize the staff, you always get opposition from the owners, the management, because, you know, whenever they see our presence, you know, their own belief is that these people are coming in. The labor people, they don't want to do anything with the union. They feel the union are a threat to their operation. But one thing they fail to understand is unionism is not just about, you know, continuous demanding for what and what from the management. The unionism is there for both management and the workers. So I don't see any reason why most of the employers are scared of unionism, because when union is in place, there is that mutual relationship between the employer and the employees. We act, I mean, as this catalyst between these two, organizations, I mean the union and the employers. But in most cases, they feel when the union are coming to the organization, they feel they are coming to, you know, threaten their existence. You know, but if you don't have skeleton in your cupboard, why would you want to be afraid of the union? Because the union is not coming to pick up your business. The union is coming to encourage your business vis-a-vis, you know, trying to get close to the employee, organize them in such a manner that they are not being cheated. You know, and all these things, there are laws that guide the labor union in this country. So I don't see reason why employers are always finding difficult when they see union executive around them. Any hotel that we organize, one thing that we do, we'll make sure that there is a condition of service for our workers. In that aspect, whenever, you know, an employee or our members are leaving that particular organization, there is a book of reference for the management to refer to in terms of settling their benefits. In a place where this are lacking, the management sits and decide whatever they feel and they give to the employees that it's given. So that is why it is very important for the hotels to be organized so that the rights of the employees are not being taken for granted. You know, our preference is always for the hotel that we have our presence. You know, if you don't have your presence in a particular hotel, you cannot just visit them. You don't have access to the staff, you don't have access to the management. But the ones that we have already organized, you know, the management knows. In short, we work like partners in progress. You know, then when there's an issue, you can quickly get to the management and then engage the employees and see whatever issue that is on ground, and mediate and see that, yes, the issue is resolved.
Concerned about the COVID-19 pandemic, the president says that the association has put into motion a plan B to make the life of retirement pleasurable to members by setting up various schemes that will impact their lives.
Right now, we have in HAPSSSA what we call we just registered my point now, HAPSSSA consults. The idea is to set up this particular segment of HAPSSSA to develop, you know, our staff. It's like those who have left the industry, bring them together and have a kind of a company that can consult other hotels, employing team members or staff that are already being trained, you know, outsourcing them to various hotels and consulting for them. That is already under development. And very soon, we'll open that particular segment with office and with staff that are then basically training of whatever that has to do with the hospitality industry, hotels and all that. Well, we have a cooperative at this moment. You know, what we're trying to do is to engage with the Federal Housing Fund and then apply for our members. The discussion is ongoing with the Federal Housing Fund while our members continue in their own contribution to the National Housing Fund.
Being an active unionist right from his early days as a staff of Transcorp Hilton Abuja, Comrade Iye has made the fight for his rights and the rights of others his major priority, which has gladly paid off.
I want to dwell mostly on organizing. There are so many hotels within all the regions that people are, you know, continuously, you know, being cheated in terms of the job that they do. If you go to most hotels now, you see a lot of casualization of workers. You know, when union exists, it is difficult for employers to embark on casualization of workers because, you know, the leadership of the union will ask one or two questions. And when this thing does not exist, the employers, you know, will take advantage of the scenario and then deal, you know, with the employees in the negative, allowing them to work excessively, overloading them with jobs and responsibilities, and at the end of the day, they go home with peanuts. Even when they lose their job, there is no terminal benefit. The employers do whatever they like, which is contrary to the ethics of labor. Well, when I took over the leadership as the national president of the association, I had a lot of vision, you know. That within my own tenure, I should be able to accomplish. And that we started vigorously. You know, my first vision is to say that the National Secretariat, where we operate from, should be a kind of a place where people can come and reckon with. A place that is fully digitalized to go with the trend of the global world that we are. And then immediately we took on, yes, we started with the renovation of the National Secretariat, equipping the National Secretariat with the IT equipment, you know, trying to organize one or two hotels. I never imagined myself being at a position where I would be leading people. But then I have this in me right from when I was in school. When I got employed at the Transcorp Hilton, I did my youth service there. And when I started seeing the leadership, the people that are, you know, at the helm of affairs, and I felt challenged that I am better positioned to do this job, even better than the people that were there. If I can do this, what stopped me from being there? And I started agitating, and I started coming out. People started seeing me. I started being vocal in meetings. And when there was an opportunity, I was being called. It was like, come and contest. And I started from vice chairman at the branch level. From there, I moved to the secretary at the branch level. From the secretary, I moved to the chairman at the branch level. And from the branch, I was identified. And then I was being projected at the national level. And last year, to God be the glory, after contest, I emerged as the national president. I believe it's an act of God. I believe that God has put in me something that can drive people to, you know, helping those that has no voice. And I believe so far I've not disappointed them.
Unionism is indeed a constitutional right for the protection of workers and creating a balance between the employer and the employee. Indeed, the president of the Hotel and Personal Services Senior Staff Association and his executives have made this their paramount objective.